Well, we saw a destroyer on the horizon coming toward Harrow Strait. And actually, before we even saw it, we heard it. And then we saw the local J-pod killer whales crowded up against the shore and also moving north away from the vessel. For an extended period of time, these whales stayed near the surface. They didn't go diving and foraging as they had been prior to the ship showing up. And they also came very close to shore. They just kept changing direction all the time, as if they were seeking some direction that would be out of this sound field. We were seeing extreme aversion or avoidance of the sounds by the porpoises and whales at 12 to 15 miles from the ship. I was present in the Bahamas in March 2000 when we had a steady population of beaked whales mysteriously began swimming ashore and stranding on the beach, all within a few hour period. There had been a sonar exercise in the area, and the Navy ultimately admitted that they were the probable cause of these strandings. Seems as though it may have been just an extreme avoidance or aversion behavior. The whales are just trying to get away from this incredibly loud, scary sound and painful sound. And they went to the beach and had a lot of problems with their vascular system and hemorrhaging. You know, the Navy needs these systems, so what they need to learn is when and where to practice. They have to practice nuclear weapon delivery too, but you don't do it downtown populated areas with people or wildlife. So, you know, first of all, they have to learn when and where, and we can help them do that. When they actually are going to conduct an exercise, that they ramp up gradually, giving whatever animals, they will try to avoid the sound, so give them a chance to get out of the area.